wanna give you a solution. Right now, today, that time is up. There's no more giving you lies. We're not African, we're not black, we're not Jamaican. We're all from the 12 tribes of Israel. That's what I want to do, Bob. And it's high time you ain't gotta speak. Christianity is a damn show. Christianity is a cost to our people.
This is reality.
That's right.
This is reality. Gonna show you why. You have to destroy yourself.
Right.
So we're supposed to give a warning.
We're not judging you, we're warning you.
But have we seen any change?
No!
Have we seen anything that has changed our people? Changed our neighborhoods?
Keep his commandments. That's how we're gonna do it. God gave you a way to dress, so follow it, sis. You a uniform for your bosses. Your bosses give you a uniform. Now the great God of the heaven and the universes gave you a dress code. Follow that dress code. Read
the book of 1 John, chapter 2 and verse 3. And hereby we do know that we know him, if we keep his commandments. He that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar.
So if you say you love God and you don't keep his commandments, you are a liar. Give me 1 Samuel chapter 2. We're gonna learn today. Because right now, as a people, we continually say we know God. We love God. We have a special relationship with God. But it's funny, when the Bible is open and God say, thus saith the Lord, our people got a problem. We immediately, the Negro heroism, all of that crap just comes back up. Oh no, I'm super Negro. I ain't gonna listen to that.
Bring it out.
Y'all need to humble yourself. Read 2 and 3.
The book of 1 Samuel, chapter 2 and verse 3. Talk no more so exceeding proudly.
So black man, black woman, Hispanic man, Hispanic woman, don't talk no more exceeding proudly. If you don't keep God's love, you don't know him. Humble yourself down. Because the prophets of the Most High God is here today to bring the news to you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Read.
Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth.
Because it's exceedingly arrogant to say I love God and you keep not his laws.
Right.
That's arrogancy. You don't know God. You don't keep his laws.
Right.
Where does his laws fit in your life?
Right.
Bring that thing out. Stand here today. We'll show you where you wrong at. Read.
For the Lord is a God of knowledge, and by him actions are weighed.
Actions are weighed.
That's right.
By God.
Right.
Not that lip service.
Right.
Not that service that say, you know what, God, I love you.
Right.
Forgive me of my sin. You know my heart. God is a God of actions. If you love him, do it.
That's right.
Keep his laws. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 11. Because one thing y'all gonna understand, we out here today to bring out them laws. Hold that. Give me James 1 and 22. Because one thing we're gonna understand, and then get after that, give me Deuteronomy 30 and 11. Because our people need to understand how to keep God's laws. The blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. We are the real Jews the Bible speak of.
That's
what we out here doing. That's what we out here to do, to bring our people this information. Read. James 1 and 22.
The book of James, chapter 1 and verse 22. But be ye doers of the word.
Be ye doers. So you hear God's laws, do it. It's not hard. Read.
Not hearers only.
Be ye doers. Don't just be hearers. For those that got their windows down, for those that are listening, don't just be hearers, be doers. Read.
Deceiving your own self.
You deceiving your own self if you're just a hearer. You gotta do. You gotta keep his laws. Read.
For if any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face.
You are like unto a man beholding your natural face. That means you definitely you gonna see your real self. You just a hearer, you not a doer.
That's right.
You a faker, you a phony. That's basically what that's going into. Now go to give me Deuteronomy 30 and 11. Because our people today, we like to have excuses. We like to say, oh, I can't keep God's laws. All his laws are done away with. We're going to learn something today. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 11.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30 and verse 11. For this commandment which I commanded thee this day.
This commandment that Moses has commanded our people through the Lord God. Today, women should not be in pants. Men should not be in dresses. We can't eat the abominable food. Pork, crab, shrimp, lobster. We can't eat these things. We must keep the Sabbath day holy. We can't cook clean work on the Sabbath day. Buy nor sell. These are commandments. Read.
It is not hidden from thee.
These laws aren't hidden from you. Those laws are not hidden from you. This book is right here, sitting on your dresser collecting dust. This book is sitting on your dashboard, absorbing the sun's heat every day. When you gonna open it? When you gonna turn the page? Read.
Neither is it far off.
It's not far off. Like I said, it's on your dresser. Right now, God's prophets is on the corner. Right. How you doing, bro? You all right? Come over here, bro. Check this sign out real quick. Check the sign out real quick. Where you fall on the sign real quick? Check that out. Wait, you see yourself on the sign right here?
Yeah.
Where you at?
Judah.
You're Judah? So you the first tribe. So you know that Christ came from this tribe, right? Give me Hebrews 7 and 14 real quick. Hey, what's your name, bro? Garen? I'm Uriel, bro. How you doing, man? Hey, what's up, bro? What's your name?
Jose?
Jose and Garen. I'm Uriel, man. Pleasure to meet y'all, brothers, man. Hey, you see yourself on the sign right here, Garen? Simeon. You from Simeon, you from Judah. So I'm letting him know that he come from the tribe of Judah, the same tribe Christ came from. Read that.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 7 and verse 14. For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
So there is evidence that Christ came from the tribe of Judah.
Right.
So you, what's your question? Y'all had any questions? What was your question? This is basically about the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. We have been enslaved throughout all our lives. We refer ourselves as black. We call ourselves black. That's the color in the crayon box. That's how we know our people. Jeremiah 17 and 4. Because our people, we lost our heritage. We were disconnected from who we are as a people. We lost God's laws. Are you paying attention, Gary? We're going to bring it out to you right now, bro. Because right now what you got to understand is, to understand God's laws, you got to understand your heritage. You got to understand where you came from. Read that.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17 and verse 4. And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage.
So we would discontinue from our heritage. Our heritage, what was our heritage? Our heritage was keeping God's laws. This Bible is who we are as a people. Read.
Thy heritage that I gave thee, and I will cause thee to serve thine enemies in the land which thou knowest not.
So God said he's going to cause us to serve our enemies in a land that we don't know. That we don't know. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28. I got you right now. Not exactly what you said. How did we get to this land right here? Right, let me get that sign. With ships, right? Okay. All right. Hey, Gary?
Jose.
Sorry about that, bro. All right, Jose. How did your people get to the land of Hispaniola?
Yeah, they were transported from Africa to the Dominican Republic.
To the west coast of Africa to the Dominican Republic. On what mode? What mode of
ship?
On slave ships. So understand something. The only difference between you two right now is between all of us actually is a boat stop. It's a boat stop. That's the only difference between us. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28. Let me get verse 15. Let me verse 15 and we're going to jump straight to 68.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass if thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I commanded thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So as the so-called Dominicans, or as the so-called black, the African-Americans, on all those that you see on the sign, if we would not follow God's laws, we would be under curses. As a people right now, we are under curses. We are cursed as a people. We are under curses. The only way for us to get from under those curses is for us to follow and keep God's laws. So now I just asked y'all a question, how did we get to the land that we're at today? I'm going to show you, according to the Bible, that this is history. This is biblical proof that we are the real Jews today. Read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 68.
Read.
And the Lord shall send thee into Egypt again with ships.
So we're going to be brought into Egypt again with ships. So understand something. In 1619, the so-called African Americans went into slavery. 200 years before that, 1492, the Hispanics were brought into slavery. To the land of Hispaniola. So now you gotta understand these two dates correlate because we're brothers. We were brought to a land where we knew not, which was Dominican Republic, which was Haiti, this side, America. These are the lands that we were brought to. Read.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again, and there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
So there, when we get to Dominican Republic, when we get to America, we're going to be sold to our enemies. Check it out right here. We're being sold. Once again, back to Deuteronomy 28 verse 15. So here, the Native Americans were being killed off by Christopher Columbus, by Ponce de Leon. The lands were being conquered. The natives were being conquered in 1492. 1619, this happened to our people. We were oppressed together.
Right.
Deuteronomy 28, verse 15. All right, I can put them down.
The book of Deuteronomy.
That's your question right now.
Chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass.
So it will happen. That means this is a future this is future prophecy speaking. Read.
If thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So if these 12 people on these 12 nations tribes on the sign right here will not follow or hearken unto the Lord thy God, read.
To observe to do all his commandments.
So we had to watch to do all of God's commandments. Read.
And his statutes which I commanded thee this day.
What's going to happen if we don't follow God's laws? Read.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So this is the answer to your question. Why did God allow the so-called white man to come over and conquer us? Because they called them the conquistadors. And on 1492, when they conquered the land of Hispaniola, 1619, when they packed the so-called African Americans like sardines on slave ships and brought them way across the transatlantic. This is history. Jump to verse 48.
Verse 48. Therefore shall thou serve thine enemies.
So the therefore is talking about, see, because you chose to break God's laws, you're going to serve your enemies. Read.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
Which the Lord shall send against us. So it's not the so-called white man who just came over and just decided to take us. No, it's because we did something. We broke God's laws. That's the reason why. Thousands of years ago, this was a prophecy. It's still prevalent today. Because when you read in Deuteronomy 28:68, it's talking about ships. Who are the only people on the face of the earth that went into slavery on ships? That's us, the blacks and Hispanics and the natives. Nobody else can stand up and say, that's me. The Chinese man can't say that. The white man in our land today that's acting like they're Jews, but they're Jewish, they can't say that. They are pretending to be us. They're pretending to be you. They're not you. Give me all Revelations 2 and 9. Hold that. Because Christ prophesied about something real quick. So now, questions? Y'all got a question? Who is the white man? Today? Okay, all right. Before I answer that, what does that pertain to your salvation? Because right now, we out here for our people to tell you, to give you God's laws, to have you to understand that the keeping of God's laws is the only way that we're going to get out of this state that we're in right now. So to understand that, we got to focus on our people. We ain't got to worry about the other nation. We ain't got to worry about the so-called white man. That's not going to, it's not going to benefit you nothing.
That's right.
We got to understand what is your purpose, what is our purpose as the 12 tribes of Israel. Huh? Hold on, hold that. He said, why don't we want to help him as well? Give me, let me see. What was your question? Okay, so you ask, what's the purpose of the white man? You say, why don't we want to help them, right? Get Ecclesiastes 12. Get Ecclesiastes 12. Huh?
Sarah.
What's your name, brother?
Sarah.
No, Ecclesiastes 12. What's your name? Garrett, what's your name, brother? Jose. So what's your nationality? Dominican, and what's your nationality? Judah. So you know you Judah. All praises. You will be from the tribe of Simeon. The so-called Dominicans and Dominican Republic are from the tribe of Simeon. Both of y'all share the same history. Y'all just in different locations, in different time periods of y'all slavery. Watch this, read.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12 and verse 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter.
So the conclusion of your life, the conclusion of your life, read.
Fear God and keep his commandments.
So before we can learn about any other nation or people, what must we learn to do? Fear God and keep his commandments, right? Read on.
For this is the whole duty of man.
So our whole duty as Israelite men, hold that sign up. Our whole duty as Israelite men is to first we got to learn of God. Do y'all agree? Because we don't know who God is. I'm going to give you an example. Who ordained us to be called Dominicans and American blacks? Huh? No, it wasn't a white man. You see? So we worried about, watch the girls there, 13 and 9. We worried about a people that has nothing to do with us. This is why, Hosea 13 and 9. Because Dominican means dog of God. You didn't know that. What does it say? Dogs of the Lord. But your slave masters called you Dominican. Your slave masters called you American, African American. Watch this, Hosea 13 and 9.
The book of Hosea, chapter 13 and verse 9.
Watch what God says. God gonna let us know why we went into slavery. Let's see if he said it's because of the white man. Read.
O Israel,
which y'all are, read.
Thou hast destroyed thyself.
Read that again.
Thou hast destroyed thyself.
So the reason why, hold the sign up, put that sign down. Hold both of these signs up, Samuel. Hold that sign up. Because this happened to the so-called Hispanics in 1492. This happened to the so-called African Americans, Jamaicans, and Haitians in 1619.
That's right.
Read that again.
O Israel, thou hast destroyed thyself.
God says the reason why yokes of chains were put around your neck is because of you. The reason why yokes of arms were put around your neck is because of us. We're the reason. We didn't obey God's commandments. That is exactly why. Get Deuteronomy 10 and 12. We you understand, brothers. The reason why we in this predicament is because of us. The reason why we call ourselves Dominican. The reason why we call, get Jeremiah 50:33. The reason why we call ourselves African American is because of us. We're the reason. Watch this, Jeremiah 50:33. Come on. Gotcha. Jeremiah 50:33.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 50 and verse 33. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel.
The children of Israel today would be the so-called Hispanics, the Cubans, the Mexicans, the Puerto Ricans, the South Americans, the Native American Indians. They will be considered the children of Israel. Watch this. Read it again.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel.
The children of Israel.
And the children of Judah.
The children of Judah would be the so-called American blacks, Haitians, and Jamaicans.
Right.
Were oppressed together.
God says y'all was oppressed together. I'm gonna show you something. Hold this sign up. What is that around his neck? That's the chain, right? These are so-called Native Americans, Boricuas, Taino Indians, and the island of Hispaniola. What is that around his neck, brother? Damn, how come this history, which is the so-called Negroes, and this history, which is the so-called Hispanics, don't they look similar? That's because they're the same. Y'all are the same people standing before us, and y'all don't even know it. Why you think your hair looks just like his hair? Woolly! Hold on, read.
Together, and all that took them captives held them fast.
They refuse to tell us who we are. They refuse to tell us that all we have to do is come together, and no nation can stand against us. What's your question, brother? Christmas. It's called Thanksgiving. It's called birthdays. It's called breaking God's laws. Read Hosea 7 and 8.
The book of Hosea, chapter 7 and verse 8. Ephraim,
which is the northern kingdom or the Hispanics. Read.
Ephraim.
Hosea chapter 7, verse 8.
Come on.
Ephraim, he admits himself among the people. So during the captivities of the northern kingdom, the Assyrians, the Babylonians, all the captivities, Ephraim have mixed themselves among the other nations. Read.
Ephraim is a cake, not turd.
You ever baked a cake? On the top of that cake, what color is it? On the bottom of that cake, what color is it? Right. It could be black. It could be light. God says, Ephraim, it's just like that. You're going to find something that look like you. You're going to find something that look like you. That's behind right. you. Hey, Jacob, turn around, Jacob. That brother is the lighter side of the cake, but he's an Israelite. Then you're looking at me. Then me. I'm the darker side of the cake. I'm an Israelite from the tribe of Gad, the so-called Native Americans. So his color don't mean nothing. It's not about color. It's about nationality. It's about who you are. Do you fit the curses in the Bible? That's what it's about. It's not about color. All right? Read what you got.
Jeremiah chapter 12, verse 9. Mine heritage is unto me as a speckled bird.
See that? The heritage is the Israelites, a speckled bird. That means some may come light-skinned, some may come dark-skinned. Hell, some of them look like they Caucasians. But that's not the point. That's not the point. What is a speckled bird? What's a speckled bird? You ever see? Right. A pigeon that black, white. You see it all the time. You see white pigeons. You see black pigeons. You see brown pigeons. It's different shades. It's different colors. But they all birds. And y'all are the same people, even though y'all look different. Sister, you too, sister. How you doing? What's your name, sister? Cassandra. What's your name again? Jose? Gare? So we got Garen, Jose, and Cassandra. We have three Israelites standing before us that don't even know it. Get Isaiah 65:15. Cassandra, what would your what would they say your nationality is? If you had to write on a application, what would you check as your nationality? African American, right? And you would check Dominican. You would check African American, but you know you Judah. All praises. Watch what God says your nationality is. Read.
Isaiah chapter 65, verse 15. And ye shall leave your name.
Your name.
For a curse.
God says ye shall leave your true biblical names of Judah, Benjamin, Levi, Ephraim, Simeon. You shall leave your biblical names.
For a curse.
What is a curse? Is a curse good or bad? It's bad. Read.
Unto my chosen, for the Lord God shall slay thee and call his servants by another name.
See that? God says he shall slay thee. Hold that sign up. Hold those signs up. We were slayed in 1619, in 1492, in slavery. God says he was going to slay his servants, and they will be called by another nationality.
Right.
Sister, you believe in God? So all three of y'all believe in God, right? So let me ask y'all something. Is our history in the Bible? You say yes. It could be what?
It could be fabricated.
You're absolutely right. Could be. What you think, Cassandra? Is our history in the Bible? Probably not the real one. Explain that. What do you mean? Okay. So I'm going to ask you, Cassandra, Jose, Garen, what do they teach us about our history in school? What do you know? Put that down. What do you know, Cassandra? We're going to start with you. We were slaves. What about you, Jose? What do they teach you about so-called Hispanic history in school? They were brought over here on ships. What about you? Slavery. What else? What else? What happened to us in slavery? Brought down as a people. What about you, Cassandra? We were brought down. What about you, Gary? Came back up. Okay, so watch this. Now, all three of y'all just named great points of our history in the school. So let's see if that history matches the prophecies in the Bible. Because if it does, you got to ask yourself, what is my history doing in the Bible? Because the Bible only talks about the Israelites. So if your history matches the history of the Israelites, what does that make y'all?
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.